Hi guys, I know it's been a long time since I've recorded a video, but it was the holidays. I was busy. I never had actual time to sit down and record things, so I finally found time. And instead of me reacting to something, I wanted to drop a different kind of video. 2020 just ended. Worst possible year anybody in their life can possibly have. Some people had it worse than others, but every single person in the world had it bad. And the fact that you're here watching my video, and the fact that you're still alive and breathing, don't take that for granted. Because 2020 could have took your life. It really could have. If you put it in that perspective, 2020 could have killed you. And that's scary. But you're here, I'm here, we're all here. Because I've had that experience in 2020. I went through a lot of stuff in 2020. Mentally and physically, I'm just happy I'm still here. But you know what made 2020 better? Honestly, if you really think about it, K-pop saved 2020 for a lot of people. I'm not kidding. K-pop saved a lot of people in 2020. For me, K-pop was like that one music that just still kept going in 2020, and it was really, really good. They came out with some really, really good songs in 2020. But I only have to pick 10. I have to choose 10 songs that made my 2020. My top 10 K-pop songs of 2020. This was hard, because I wanted to do top 20, but then I was just like, I told myself I wouldn't really sit down and think about it, because that's like 20 songs. I could legit just throw songs in there and like make people just like, G-Friend's in there, oh, Mamamoo's in there, oh, everybody's in there. No, I didn't want to do that. I want to put my top 10 songs so then I can actually sit down and think about which songs I enjoyed in 2020. For me, songs have to hit me and stay with me for the entire year, or if it just came out, it's still stuck in my head. So let's see what this list is about. So there's gonna be my top 10, and there's gonna be some honorable mentions, because you know I have to mention some songs that I still listen to, but it's not like one of those kind of songs, but I liked it to a point where it's still on my list and I still listen to it. So let's start with number 10. Number 10, it just came out, honestly, and it legit is on my favorite album of 2020. My favorite album of 2020 was Fatal Love. Came out at the end of 2020. I know it's kind of, but it's at the end of 2020.
That's right, you look in my eyes, straight into my eyes, and just say, I want you eat me like a main dish. To go a day to the hot dish, eating clish, but I'm gonna pass it. That's from the jacket, joke, you girl, want it hot.
So, Love Killer by Monsta X is my number 10. Why? Because it came out at the end of the year, one. By like the end of the year, one. And two, it's a really nice song. You listen to it, and it gives you that feel of like intensity and Monsta X-ness, you know what I mean? Like, it's really, really good. And Monsta X by far is like one of the best K-pop groups of like 2020. And I'm not just saying that because I love Monsta X. It's because they've been through so much in 2019, and the fact that they pushed themselves to accomplish as much as they accomplished in 2020 just tells you how hard they have to fight in order to do. They don't get the recognition they deserve, unfortunately, but the fact that they're still pushing and they're still doing what they love, I love them for that. But yeah, Love Killer is my number 10. It's such a great song. It's so good. And no, I'm not just going to keep sitting here saying it's so good for each song, but I might. Okay, so that was my number 10. My number 9 is... I do. because it's a really touching song. I mean, it's very hype and it's really good, and it has like this Latin like vibe to it, but it's also very touching because it just tells you that she went through a lot of stuff in 2020. Was it 2020? No, 2019. It either year you look, Wassa went through a lot of stuff. Mamamoo in general went through a lot of stuff in 2019, 2020. People just don't know when to stop, do they? So then Wassa came out with a song called Maria. And it shows you her different side of herself. And then the ending to that music video just, oh, it touches you. So, because she feels like alone. But then her sisters, her three other sisters, Solar, Moonbool, and Wien, come in and be like, it's okay, we got you. We got you. It's okay, don't worry about it. I love that. Maria is a really good song. Like, it's like Twit. It's like one of those, it legit is like Twit. It's like one of those songs that it's in your playlist, and when it comes on, you're just like, oh, I remember this song. Oh, it's good. Oh, it's really good. So yeah, Maria is my number 9 song of 2020. I really hope one of these days, Mamamoo, I mean, they get the recognition for like best vocalist, best like K-pop vocalist by far. It's no lie that their vocals are like on point. It's just, I wish that people would leave them alone. Like, seriously. Let them be them, and you do you. You don't need to be hawking over them, everything they do. Just like, oh, they did this. No, leave them be, okay? They don't do anything wrong. It's just, you're just on their case all the time. It's really annoying. A lot of it's really annoying. But, yeah. Maria Awasa is my number 9. Number 8, I had to pick between either Apple Omega and Apple. Apple slaps. My G-Friend is so good. Like, I would legit sit there and listen to Apple for hours because it's so good. And then you remember the music video, the concept, the bad witches, you know, the G-Friend pulling off a dark concept. You never thought they could, but they did. They did, and they killed it. That little walk that they do in the choreo. I'm so happy that G-Friend is doing them and not listening to other people. Because I know a lot of people don't like the fact that G-Friend went from, like, schoolgirl, like, concept to this, like, adulthood thing that they're going on. But I feel like the maturity that they're going through is something that G-Friend needed to do. I mean, a lot of people didn't like it, but I love it, because eventually at some point, a K-pop group, when they start off young, they have to switch their concept once they get older. They can't continue the whole happy-go-lucky like concept all the time. But I'm happy G-Friend, I mean, of course they were maturing, but they matured in their music, you know what I mean? They gave us Apple as their whole, like, coming of age kind of thing. It was something that I've actually was waiting for. When I got into G-Friend, I was like, oh, their concept is so nice and sweet. And in the back of my mind, I was just like, I wonder if they're ever going to try and do a dark concept or a different kind of concept. And when they did, I legit lost my mind. I swear to God, that was the coolest. That was the coolest, like, transition from what they used to give us to what they are giving us now. And then honorable mention, Mago, just the icing on top of the cake. It was just a really good change for GFriend. I know a lot of people are just like, oh no, we're losing my GFriend. You're not losing GFriend. They're just trying something new. Trying something new is scary, yes, and some people won't like it. But the fact that they're trying it out, they're testing the waters, is what tells you that they're evolving. They're accepting change. They want to see what they can do with what they have. And I love it. I love it. Absolutely love it. So yeah, Apple GFriend is my number 8. Honorable mention, Mago. Number 7. I could not have a K-pop list of 2020 and not add my boy August D. Desuata. I have to make sure I'm saying that right, because sometimes I'm just like, I don't know how to say it. Yeah, that song. August D Part 2. August D D2 from his album. That song was amazing. That song is absolutely fire. Anything based... August D, aka Suga, aka Minyoongi, is legit by far my favorite rapper in, like, K-pop. Don't come at me for that. I got into K-pop through BTS, and Yoongi kind of... Yoongi's one of my favorite rappers in K-pop, because I got into K-pop through BTS, and Yoongi, August D, legit just justified, like, when I listen to rappers have to sound like that to me. If they don't sound like that to me, I don't want to hear it. I really don't want to hear it. But yeah, and it's really nice. His flow, his rhyme, his rhythms, everything that August D does is just really nice. And Desuata, it's an interesting concept the way he approached Desuata, because he's just like, he found out that August D became famous, but he really didn't want to become famous. August D, Suga, aka Minyoongi, has always said that he didn't want to become famous. He doesn't like the famous aspect of what he does. And August D became king, forgetting where he started. So then August D, from where he started, had to come back and remind the king where you came from. Beautiful. I love it. I love the concept. I love the idea. It's really cool. Song's fire. I could not add August D to my K-pop list of 2020. I could not. Like, excuse me. But yeah, that was my number 7. August D, but August D's Desuata, August D. Okay, my number 6, I just found him in 2020, fell in love with him in 2020, follow him on Twitter in 2020, and I absolutely love the video I found of him in the beginning of, not the beginning of 2020, in the middle of 2020, somewhere like that. It was Lay's Lit. Look at me go, go. You're making it so, look at me go, go. You know what I'm saying. That song is lit. That song, the music video, everything about it, Lay himself, lit. Oh my god, I've never seen such production in a music video in my life. That's crazy. That was crazy. I remember watching that, right? And I was sitting there just like, what? No, what happened was I was lying in my bed, right? And then somebody sent me a message on YouTube saying you should react to Lay's Lit. And I was like, okay, fine. Because usually when people give me like recommendations, I'm just like, I'm scared. I don't want to do it. So I'll think about it and I'll come back. But somebody sent me a recommendation for Lay's Lit. And I was like, I should give it a shot. Just like get up out of my bed and I'll give it a shot. So I reacted to it. And lo and behold, that song, the production, everything about it came out of Lay's pocket. I forgot how much it was, but that's crazy. And then, oh my God, I swear that song, the song itself is amazing, but the music video. And the music video is not the reason why it's on the list. The song is the reason why it's on the list. The song is amazing because the song is lit. But the music video is on a whole nother level of crazy. I absolutely love Lay. I heard when I was on my break, I heard that he came out. He opened his own company and he's gonna start doing things. I can't wait for him to start doing things, and I'm gonna be following him all over the place. I'll be like, Lay, hi. But yeah, I can't wait to start reacting to his new, like, more things from Lay. And I really honestly cannot wait. It's gonna be crazy because I love Lay. I just watched Lit from Lay, and then I watched a lot of other songs from Lay. And Lay's from, he used to be in EXO, right? And why is everybody from SM just like really, really talented? Just really, really talented. Oh, that's so crazy. But yeah, that's my number six. Lay's Lit. My number five is Criminal by Taemin. That song, Criminal by Taemin. That song is a song in and of itself. Like, it's so good. It's so good. I remember, because I listened to it when I was on my break. I had a mental problem and things like that. I was on my break, and Taemin dropped something. And then I was on my Twitter, and all of a sudden everybody started talking about Taemin. I was like, Taemin? Isn't Taemin from Super M? But isn't also Taemin from SHINee? And SHINee's SM. So I clicked on it. It was early in the morning. I clicked on it just to check it out. Because I'm not a fan of Super M. And I wasn't a fan of SHINee. But I wanted to check it out. Because I was getting into NCT 127. Who's from SM. And at the time, Super M was promoting. And then around the end of Super M's promotion, Taemin dropped a song. And I was like, let me check it out. Taemin's voice is amazing. Taemin's voice is so good. I don't understand it. It's just his vocals are like very soothing. It's very seductive, you know? And then Criminal seductive. And then the choreo for Criminal, oh, it's so like Michael Jackson-ish. And yes, I know Taemin's the Michael Jackson of K-pop. If you know me, my pop idol is Michael Jackson. I absolutely love Michael Jackson. I cried when I found out that he died. I was in a grocery store when I found out that he died. I cried in the middle of everybody. I legit bawled out. I'm actually like tearing up right now just speaking about it. But Michael Jackson is my pop idol. Like, I love him so much. When I was younger, I used to dance like him quite often. And the fact that when I watched Criminal by Taemin, because when I watched Taemin, like, I wasn't really into Super M, and I don't really know Taemin too much. But when I was watching Criminal and Idea, I realized that a lot of his dance moves are a representation of Michael Jackson. And I was like, what is this? This is crazy. And then I saw in the comments that people were just like, yeah, he's definitely the Michael Jackson of K-pop. And I can see that. I can definitely see that. Taemin is a idol alone and with other people. He's so good. Taemin. He's so good. Okay, enough of me talking about Taemin and Criminal. But yeah, that was my number 5, because Criminal just blew me away. And the fact that it's Criminal, and then Michael Jackson has a song called Smooth Criminal, I was like, what? Don't start with me, boy. Anyway, so that was my number 5. My number 4, it just came out around the end of 2020, but I absolutely love it so much. He dropped a music video to go along with it. I'm so sad that people weren't streaming this music video to hype it up more. But he deserves all the love in the world for dropping a mixtape that apparently nobody wanted. People asking him to drop a mixtape, and yet they didn't do anything with it. But it's Psyche by Chohan, because that's my psyche, y'all.
I wanna be like Michael, but I'm not a moonwalker. 'Cause I'm always moving forward when I'm landing at the brand. Go yard, the palm 잡으면 reaction, no guard. The pro don't see through, I need the boulder. 그 뚫어보는 차만 한 눈빛을 하나같이 충혈되시 보일 것 같게 무서워, yard.
That song I listen to every day. That song I listen to every freaking day. It's so good. Smokey is a good song. Smokey, I swear to God, is an amazing song. It's emotional. It's touching. It's by far amazing. But Psyche is the type of music I listen to. Psyche is one of those songs I'm just like, 'cause that's my psyche. That verse, that one sentence in that song, so hype. That's it. That one song, somebody says Psyche, that's the first thing that comes in my head. Legit. Somebody always says Psyche. After Psyche dropped, every time somebody says Psyche, that's the first verse that comes in my head, because that's my Psyche. That's how good that song is. I swear to God, Psyche by Chohan needs more love. I'm so upset that it didn't get as much love as it should have. It needed more love. I love that song to bits. I streamed it, but it wasn't enough. I don't understand you guys. Anyway, you guys ask for somebody to drop something and then you don't do anything with it. It's really weird. But Psyche is a really great song. It's so good. It's so Chohan, really. And then he mentioned Michael Jackson. He's like, what did he say? I'm not a moonwalker, 'cause I'm always moving forward. His love for Michael Jackson is my love for Michael Jackson. If I was writing music, I would be mentioning Michael Jackson mostly in all my songs. Why? Don't know. My number 4 was Psyche by Chohan, because that song was absolutely amazing. Hype song, fire, everything about it was absolutely amazing. The music video, so Chohan, that's it. My number 3, I have to put on the list. I mean, from the beginning, these are the people who got me into K-pop. And me jumping around and finding other groups, I'm kind of not as involved with them as I usually am. But, and I'm not really a big fan of the album that this came off of, but it's a really good song that came out of 2020. It was Black Swan.
I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it.
Black Swan by BTS is my number three. Why? Because I remember when it dropped. They did the classical one first, the one that had the dancers to it. And I was like, oh, that's very nice. It's very, like, traditional? Is that how you say it? It's very traditional, very artsy and whatnot, and I loved it. And then they dropped the actual, like, Black Swan song. And I remember I played that song for 24 hours straight. No lie. On repeat for 24 hours straight. What? I know I keep saying I play this song every day, but this song I legit played for 24 hours straight on repeat and didn't get sick of it once. Not once. Black Swan is so good. I know this, I don't know if it's the chorus or the pre-chorus or the song. The song is just amazing. I'm not falling out of love with BTS. It's just they're not getting my attention as much as they used to. But Black Swan was absolutely fire. Absolutely fire. And then honorable mention was On, but On was good too, because it's very like inspirational and very like up. It's very inspirational. That's what On is to me. But Black Swan is on my list of number three of my top 10 songs of 2020. My number two, I was fighting between my number two and my number one, because they both came out in the beginning of the year. Well, one came out in the beginning of the year, the second came out in the middle of the year, kinda. But my number two is Kick It by NCT 127. Don't groan. I play that song every damn day. I play that song every... It came out in the beginning of the year. I play that song every day. I still play that song. It's so good. It's... The lyrics to this song is so weird and, like, all over the place. It's just... That song... It's just fire. And the choreo to it, it's very simple, and but it's so fire. It's just, let me introduce you to some ick. Let me introduce you to some good things. I don't know why I'm embarrassed that my number two is Kick It, but my number two is Kick It by SJ127. Don't look at me like that. I don't know. It's just something about Kick It and the fact that they added Bruce Lee into there. And I feel like NCT 127 would have been the only group to actually pull that off. I don't know why, but they did a really good job with that. And then the whole wah and the Bruce Lee noises and the yellow and black and then Yuta Nakamoto. Because Kick It wasn't my first introduction to NCT 127. It was Superhuman, but I started stanning NCT 127 after Kick It. Because I realized there was this guy named Yuta Nakamoto in NCT 127 and I wanted to find out more about NCT 127. So here I am, falling in love with NCT 127. One of these days, the poster's gonna end up on my wall, and if it's just about Yuta Nakamoto, I'll be perfectly fine with it. Yes, I am a bias of Yuta Nakamoto, if you didn't notice, if you didn't know. Because I noticed, like, a lot of time when I make a post, it's a picture of Yuta, because I love Yuta. He's so funny. But yeah. Number two is Kick It. I really have nothing else to say about Kick It, because Kick It is just a bunch of noise. Kick It legit is just a bunch of noise. The lyrics really make no sense to me. The lyrics make absolutely no sense to me. I have no idea what they're saying. And it's like, where's my roof at? It's my birthday. Let me introduce you to some things. I don't know what, I don't understand it, but the song is so good. I'm gonna stop. I'm just gonna move on to my number one because I don't understand. Oh, okay. So if you know me, you already know what my number one is. If it wasn't my number two, it's my number one. You know what my number one is. My number one is God's Menu by Stray Kids. Also, ship show. We got get a chum menu, Kakuru Kito ship show. Shikato, come on, man, to catch, catch. China Kato Nakun, and be to get catch, 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 come on, beat, catch. That song is by far my favorite song of 2020. Why? It's just the way it starts, the music video that came with it. All the SWAT team, like when they were doing the promotion for God's Menu, you could see that they changed a lot, like their confidence from what happened with them with that guy changed a lot. I love God's Menu for their confidence that it gave them. Not saying that Stray Kids didn't have confidence, it's just they're in that time in 2019. When they had to go through that nonsense with that guy, they kind of felt a little bad and they felt like they were the reason. But then they're just like, okay, we're eight. That's it. That's point blank period. We're eight and we got to show people that we are eight members of Stray Kids. Let's drop this song called God's Menu. I swear, God's Menu, the way God's Menu starts with Chungbin, Mojo Shift, yeah, that the ending and the beginning gets me all the time. The middle is so smooth, it's so nice, but like the beginning and the ending gets me all the time. Cause when I start the song, and the song starts ending, it's so good. It's and then I just have to repeat it over and over again because it just like replaced. But yeah, I love God's Menu so much. It's so good. And that's my God's Menu by Stray Kids, my number one song of 2020. Cause I got I love the song so much that I actually got the poster that came with the album. What was it? Go Live? I had to support them with that song. I just had to. But yeah, that was my list. That was my list of my songs of 2020. I know it's kind of like lackluster and boring and it's not very like spontaneous and surprising, but those are the songs I listened to throughout 2020, and I swear to God, it's and the honorable mentions I threw in there here and there, but yeah, those songs made my 2020 and I'm actually really happy about them. But yeah, so tell me in the comments what you guys thought about my list. Tell me in the comments what your list is. Is my number one your number one? Is my number 10 your number 10? Did I put people in wrong places? I don't know. But that's my opinion. You can't attack me for my opinion. But tell me in the comments what your top 10 songs are or your top song of 2020 was. And I'll see you guys in the next video.